So this is a demo of my senior project that I worked on with three other people. Pretty neat thing, I think. We had what, like 3 months, 2.5 months to do this, and I think we can be proud of the results we achieved. It's pretty neat, especially when compared to the other senior projects. Anyways, so here it is. You can see some of the moves that we added. Kind of stupid. It's, moves are pretty well redundant, really. You only need to, like, do attacks. You can cheat with those throwing stars or whatever. And you can see the enemies that I programmed there wandering around. Basically, they use A-star search to find where they want to find, and they have guard points, as it were, that are set, so they'll wander between those guard points, and if the player is within a certain range, then they'll go after the player instead. Otherwise, they'll proceed to their next guard point and continue on. As you can probably tell, we made a lot of simplifications for this project. It's basically just a normal 2D grid that you can walk on. And you can cheat with the throwing stars, as I think I said. Here's one of the battle scenes. On the bridge, you can see the wonderful water we added. And you can see the one of the stupidities of the AI. I'll just run away. And if you're right there. But whatever. And you can see some more of me cheating here. Throwing it through the through the rocks to get a guy that's not going to move because he has no guard points. Only has one, basically. And I'm not within range, so he's not going to move. So yeah, I just cheat and throwing stars at him until he dies. You can see the lava moving. Pretty neat. This is maybe my favorite level. I think it's pretty well done. Looks pretty good from a considering. Yeah, it's pretty small. You can see we have the energy thing down there at the bottom, that little gray bar there. Oh, and yep, you need to collect all the items and kill all the bad guys in each level to move on. Pray to that glowy thingy. Wonderful loading screen. This is our stupid Easter egg room that we added it at 3 in the morning the night before it was due because we were just so confident in what we did, and we added an Easter egg room with our professors there. Whatever. This is also another one of my favorite levels. Nice and colorful, and you all the bushes and flowers and stuff. Looks pretty neat, I think. I got the water too. And after that level is the final level. I guess there's a castle and there's like 5 guards there. So you have to take care of these guards to win the game. Some of them are, I think the blue ones are the toughest and the orange ones are in between or whatever. That was a tough one. Although he looks like kind of a weenie there. Yada yada yada. that move cracks me up. And some of the other moves I don't think I've shown yet. Kicking and punching and roundhouse kick there. Boom. And last but not least, the big bad boss dude or whatever. He nearly killed me. That would have sucked. I need to pray for almost dying there. And here we have the end, and I'll let you enjoy the rest of it.
One, two, three into the four. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door, ready to make an entrance, so back on up, cause you know we're about to rip shit up. Give me the microphone first so I can bust like a bubble. Compton and Long Beach together, now you know you in trouble. Ain't nothing but a G-thang, baby. Two low-death niggas, so we're crazy. Death Row is the label that pays, man. Unfadable, so please don't try to fake this. But back to the lecture at hand. Perfection is perfected, so I'ma let them understand from a young G's perspective. And before me dig on a bitch, I have to find a contraceptive. You never know, she could be earning her man and learning her man, and at the same time burning her man. Now you know I ain't with that shit, Lieutenant. Ain't no pussy good enough to get burned while I'm offended. And that's realer than real deal, holy feel. And now you hookers and hoes know how I feel. Well, if it's good enough to get broke off a proper chunk, I take a small piece of some of that funky stuff. It's like this and like that and like this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this and like that and like this and Drake creeped to the mic like a fan.
Well, I'm beeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping, but I damn near got caught, cause my beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt. So sit back, relax, and strap on your seatbelt. You've never been on a ride like this before, with a producer who can rap and control the maestro. At the same time with the dope rhyme that I kick, you know and I know I flow some old funky shit to add to my collection.